Greetings, minions! I am your humble narrator, Uncle Sideways, and I'm just here with some more Let's Play this here 5 days, a stranger on that there PC. And we just woke up on day 4 to find that we've killed Philip Harty. And we're locked up, so yeah, let's try and see how we see if we're getting at it. It's locked. God knows where they found the key. This is actually a fucking solid question. Stuck shut. Talk? Well, it won't answer me. Talk to the window. Hello? Is anyone out there? Quiet. Simone? Is that you? Yes, I'm keeping guard. Why? Shut up! You killed Philip! Don't even try to deny it.
I did?
Don't play games with me. I'm keeping guard here until the police get into the grounds. Then I'm handing you over.
Simone?
What do you want now?
What makes you think I killed Philip, anyway?
Oh, well, let me see. First, Jim and I are attacked by some huge guy in a welding mask and an apron with a machete. We manage to get away. Then we come into the kitchen and find a huge guy in a welding mask and apron unconscious next to Philip's corpse. And when we took the mask off, lo and behold, it's you.
Look, you've got it all wrong.
Oh, really? Well, then let's hear your version.
I was possessed by the ghost.
Oh, now that impresses me.
Do you think of that all by yourself? It's the truth, I swear.
Shut up. Just shut up. I mean, it's a fucking solid argument. Ah, oh, don't say that. It possessed me just like it did when I killed AJ. Well, you don't know you killed AJ.
Just go and have a look in the basement. There's two corpses down there, Sir Roderick and Sir Matthew Defoe. And take a look through those books I was carrying. There's a ghost here, I swear.
Trollboy, I'm not going to let you drag me into your lunatic fantasy. Just keep your mouth shut. No, because if I keep my mouth shut, I don't get out of here and the Let's Play doesn't continue, so...
Simone, what do you want now?
You're making a terrible mistake.
Oh, am I? Why is that?
The real killer's still on the loose.
Oh, sure. I suppose they knocked you out, dressed you in their clothes, put their machete in their hand, and cleverly hid while we discovered you.
Something like that.
Oh, please. That's a fair point, though. It does also directly contradict what you already said there, Trilbs.
What have you done with my tie?
It was Jim's idea.
We took it off you so you wouldn't hang yourself.
Why wouldn't you want me to hang myself if I'm such a cold-blooded killer?
Jim still seems to think you might somehow be innocent. That boy really admired you, you know.
I am filled with shame, I'm sure.
Where's Jim? So you can track him down and kill him?
He knows that I'm innocent.
Does he? You almost hacked him to pieces with a machete. I think he'll have taken that into consideration. Shit. What are you doing with my tie? It was Jim's idea.
Weird only two things to keep with me.
I'm trying to think what else I can do, really. It's locked. God knows where they found the key. I guess we just have to keep talking to Simone until we can, like, convince her.
Make a terrible mistake. Oh, why is that? Police will never get in here. The house will only let people in one by one. And even if an officer gets inside, they can't leave.
Well, shut up about your stupid haunted house theory. One good solid battering ram to the front door, then come and go as they please.
Fair point.
Where's Jim?
If you left him alone, he's already dead.
Shut up. The real killer's still out there. He could be creeping up on you even as we speak.
I said shut up.
Don't tell a mistake. Well, I've already done that one. I think maybe we just have to, like, what do you think? I killed Philip anyway. The real killer tricked me. I'm putting his open mask.
Where's the thing where I could have said I killed AJ?
Phil tried to kill me first.
Oh, I see. You killed Phil in self-defense.
Yeah. Okay.
Have you ever watched a horror movie? There's always someone who gets wrongfully accused of the killings, and whoever does the accusing is destined to be horribly murdered next. That's a proven fact. There's no way denying it. What are you doing with my tie? Come on. It's got to be something. How did I... You could be in terrible danger. I know. Until the police are handcuffed, we all are. Possessed by the ghost. There I go. It possessed me just like I did. Looks like I did when I killed AJ. What are you talking about now? The ghost. Trying to make things, me do things, evil things. Shut up. It never leaves me alone. I can't sleep. Then I have the blackouts. I wake up with blood all over me in an unfamiliar place. It's happened so many times now I can't count them. Shut up! Kill AJ, kill Philip, kill everyone. It wouldn't leave me alone. I'm warning you. I'm delirious with guilt most of the time. I see the face of every poor innocent I've killed every time I close my eyes. Most evenings I cry so hard I vomit several times. Sometimes I just want this nightmare to end. If death came right now, I'd welcome it. Oh, God. Simone, let me have my tie back. Your tie? Please. Oh, to hell with it. Have it, you psycho. Sick. Sick. Sick, 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 sick. I've got... No, fucking... No, come on, game. Pick the... No, not the door! Come on, man! You're better than this. Tie! Just slip it on. And here's my emergency lockpick. And see, this demonstrates the importance of forethought. You didn't have the fucking forethought to, like, you know, have that on you originally. He broke into a house and didn't take his lockpicks. This man's a fucking awful thief. This man's, like, actually just an awful thief. Where's Simone got to now? I've got to get her and Jim to believe me about the idol. I cannot see this going well. Ah, Phil. Really would rather not touch him. It's Philip. Someone has run him through with a machete. The worst part of it is that someone's probably me. Yeah, it's a bit grim. Got the bone. Look at the bones! Oh, good. It's okay, great. So, this is just... Portrait of a skeleton safari suit. The plaque reads Sir Roderick Defoe. It's a bloody skeleton in a safari suit. Actually, if we're gonna be technical, the thing is actually just turned into a living fucking nightmare over there. Well, Tom, I guess time to do a sweep to see what the hell's available right now. I'm not gonna click on the TV. I don't care about what the news is saying. It's probably just saying we're still missing. Can you take the rifle? Well, this thing's heavier than it looks. I'm not carrying this around everywhere. Better find a place to put it down. Cool. Looks like someone's been doing a little tidying up. Is the... I assume that... No. Cool, okay. Well, that reaction tells me that... At least tells me that the idol is still in there. So that works. That's good, I guess. Whether this painting isn't a nightmare at the moment. Let's go upstairs. Just check every room, I guess. Nope, still fuck all in it. Check the library. I'm gonna check books on the occult again, actually. I think any of these could be useful at the moment. Well, fair enough. Thought I'd check anyway. To deal with ghosts, it might be worth actually having a book that talks about ghosts. Nope, sweet FA in here. It's actually a problem that this fucking game has. No one in here either. Where the hell is everyone? Trilby! Simone, before you say anything... I know you didn't really kill Philip or AJ. You do? I figured you were lying to get me away from the shed. I saw him again. Who? The killer! The guy in the welding mask. I spotted him downstairs, but he didn't see me. And I can't find Jim anywhere. Simone, you have to listen to me. The ghost... Oh, shut up, you ghost. This isn't a ghost. It's a regular flesh-and-blood psycho. Speak of the devil? Do something! Sure. Oh my god. Jim? Day 5. How is he? He's awake. He's fine. He doesn't remember anything, just like I didn't. Look, I only sort of half believe this possession thing right now, but in the absence of a better suggestion, I guess I'm going along with it. Have you been going over what those books I was carrying? Yeah, some of the texts on the occult. Apparently, if we want to destroy this thing, we have to get the spirit back to its old body. That'll make it quasi-mortal. It'd still be dangerous, but not unkillable. We have to find the body first. To do that, we have to know who the ghost is. I've been thinking about this, and I have a fairly workable theory. Yes, a couple of ideas about it myself. Right, well, the ghost is something to do with the disappearance of Roderick and Matthew Defoe, right? The deaths and disappearances all started after that. Agreed. So, what do you think? I think Sir Roderick had more than one son. Yes! Because of what I read in Sir Roderick's diary, exactly, he makes reference to some monster he helped create, and he doesn't mean Matthew. And Matthew talks about another boy in the house, a boy behind the door in the kitchen. Those manacles indicate that someone was kept imprisoned in the basement. Where do you think this other son came from? Want to hear what you think first. I think Sir Roderick fathered a love child while in Africa. The evidence doesn't support that. Nah, I guess it was the African idol throwing me off. I think Belinda gave birth to twins the night she died. Yeah, that was the idol was what threw me off. Ah, yes, I see where you're going. Found Belinda's death certificate. She died about 20 minutes after Matthew was already out. I think it was the second son that did her in. Sir Roderick went practically insane with grief, blamed the poor kid for her death, kept him in the basement, refused to even acknowledge his existence. Can you imagine what that must have been like for the boy? Growing up in a filthy grotto like some kind of animal, given no education, no love, it'd be like living in the north. The boy would be completely retarded and insane, like people from the north. He probably couldn't tell the difference between one person and another. For the record, I'm from the north. That's why he kills absolutely everyone who enters the house. He thinks they're all Sir Roderick come to torment him some more. What happened on that day 15 years later when Sir Roderick and Matthew disappeared? You found their corpses in the basement, so they're obviously murdered. Question is, how and why? Sir Roderick went mad and tried to kill him. Yes! Remember in Sir Roderick's diary, the last entry? He talks about destroying the monster. He must have gotten really drunk, and it being the anniversary of Belinda's death didn't help. He went down to the basement and beat the poor kid to death. Half to death. Matthew found the body afterwards and tried to bandage him up. Matthew wasn't the sharpest tool in the box. His brother lived on for a bit longer. Long enough to get a mask and a machete and to kill both his father and Matthew. Then he must have died of his wounds. Jesus. I'm gonna try and destroy his ghost? None of anything that happened to him is his own fault. What little mind he had is no more. All he has now is hate. If we don't kill him, he'll kill us all. There's no reasoning with him. I suppose you're right. It's very sad, really. So what will you do now? I'm going to find his body. Then I'm going to figure out how to bring his soul back to it and destroy him. Well, let me know if I can be of any help. I will. Good luck. Thanks. I'm going to go to the void where I'm like... She's just going to like quietly disappear back to the void where she is in between me, like... specific things. Okay, let's check the books on the occult. Something in here about summoning angry spirits. Cool. We got a good magic book and a bad magic book. The arts of black magic and necromancy. Summoning angry spirits to their bodies. Murderous wraiths are nigh indestructible when they can hop from body to body, but tying them down to their old bodies returns them to partial mortality, a state in which they can be destroyed. Simply enough, place the spirit's original body in a place of fire and death, return it its own clothes, then read aloud the following passage, omitting nothing. It's just a load of gobbledygook here. When I want to read it out, I should use the book on myself. Warning, the summoning of a wraith will also bring forth other unquiet spirits who will haunt those who hold their possessions. Cool. Sunbleached skull. It's just a skull there. Can I take the skull? I don't want this nasty thing. Okay, can't take the skull. Cool. Fair enough. Fair enough, I guess. Valid response. Okay. So we need to find his body. It's a blank canvas. Yeah, that it is. That is indeed a blank canvas. Hi, Phil. Yeah, you're still not great, are you? So Roderick and Matthew. I'm trying to think where the pissing. I'm trying to think where the hell else he could be, honestly. Or where his body could be, I should say. Because yeah, I just don't know where his corpse would actually be. Not a good time to disturb the dead. Okay, fair enough. God damn it, I clicked off the screen again. Most perturbing. Where could his corpse be? I mean, because part of me just reckons it should probably be down here. Otherwise, disturb the sleep of the dead. Interact with the manacles? They're quite firmly attached to the wall. Don't have anything that could remove them. Chains. Are these manacles? What the hell is this room used for? Well, we know what it was used for. Right. Sorry, I'm not doing great commentary right now, because I'm just trying to figure out where on God's green earth he could have got to. Oh, maybe I should go check on Jim, actually. It's just a... Maybe I should actually go see how Jim's doing. Because we need that fucking... We need the dude, the guy's stuff. So maybe we should, like, get his stuff. Assuming Jim still has his stuff. Jim, what happened to his stuff? Mr. Trilby? Yes, Jim. Can I ask you a favor? Sure. I still have the mask and apron and the knife from last night. Could you take them away and throw them away for me? I really don't like having them around. Sure. Thank you. No, thank you, Jim. Yes? How are you feeling? My head still hurts a bit. I feel a bit woozy. Apart from that, I'm fine. What happened last night, exactly? Well, me and Miss Taylor were in the living room, and this big man entered in a mask and tried to kill us with a big knife. We were able to get away, but then we heard Mr. Harty screaming. Miss Taylor told me to wait here. A bit later, she came back and told me that it was you in the mask. I didn't really believe that. She went off to keep guard or something, and then went into this trophy room and found this wooden doll thing on the floor, and next thing I remember was in the bathroom and my head really hurt. Did I try and kill you? No. But something did, through you. I don't like this place anymore, Mr. Trilby. You and me both. So, yep. Okay, so at least we've now got, like... We've now got, his stuff, but... We need a bloody corpse. I can't think where his pissing corpse would even be. Let's try this one more time, see if I can get a nightmare. Nope, not getting a horror. But yeah, I'm trying to figure out where the Pissinella's corpse could be. I mean, it seems like I may be able to interact with those manacles. So maybe there? Maybe I can use the machete to pry the manacles off the wall. Maybe that's a thing I can do. I mean, probably not, but it's worth a shot. Use machete on chains. See what happens. That doesn't work. Okay, great. But you did actually bring me all the way down here. Don't want to use that on myself. No, you know what? Fair. It is entirely fair to not want to put that on after the fact that it... Well, we don't know that that possesses you, but it seems... It's not safe fucking with that thing. Do you know what I mean? I I mean, are there any other... I don't think there's any other, like, hidden rooms or anything in the mansion. I think we've got access to everything right now. Though we do, like, weirdly still have the teddy. Like, I don't know why we still have the teddy. That's odd to me. Simone? Trilby? What am I supposed to be doing again? You need to find the ghost's original body, then find a way to bring its soul back, then destroy the body and the soul together. Okay. Where could the body be? I don't know. You see, I found the body in the basement, so alright. Maybe you should use the same keen body hunting abilities you used then. What? Skizzers? Okay, I've got some skizzers. Finding a person with possession. Dip tie the possession in question to a stick and dip it in salt. Next, wave it over the place where the subject sleeps. Okay, so we've got his possessions, but we don't... We don't exactly have anything to tie it to. We don't have a stick or anything to tie it to. Oh, wait, hang on. Can I use the skizzers on the telephone? That doesn't work. Okay. Maybe on the other cord? Like, there's another cord on the TV. Yeah, there's the one that actually does something, so... That doesn't work. I mean, because a room, like, a place of death and fire. Sold. Do you know what I mean? We got a place full of fucking dead animal heads, so we know where the place of fucking death and fire is. And I've got, like, his stuff, but I need a fucking stick. Why? I don't even have my grolly anymore. Like, I just need a fucking... Will it let me dip anything in salt here? Use scissors on apron? Oh, I've got a thin strip off the apron, okay. Use that on machete? Machete and strip. Use machete and strip in salt. Doesn't work. Need a stick. What the hell can I use as a stick, though? That's the problem. I need a fucking stick. Nothing else. Use on that, they won't go together. Use it on scissors, no. On thick. Wait, what? Oh, okay, so I'm using. Okay, cool. So I use the machete as a stick. The fact that it's sharp meant that never occurred to me. Nope, that's not what I actually meant to do. There we go. Dip the mask in some salt. Lovely, salty mask. Yep, salty mask and machete. Fantastic, and the fucker was chained to the wall, so we know exactly where he slept. So let's just wave it around. This is where he slept. Yep, he's chained to the walls all the time. And look at that. Indicating upwards. Somehow he's going to be buried above them. Okay, upstairs we go. Indicating upwards. Does it mean... The problem is, does it mean up as in... I assume it means up as in upstairs rather than, like, north. Do you know what I mean? At least you gotta fucking hope that's what it means. Although, where the fuck could he possibly be upstairs? Look. Indicating to my right. Still to the right? To the right. Yeah, so his right is this way, yeah. Indicating to my right. Right, so I guess if we stand here, it should either say forwards or to the right. Indicating to the right. He's in the bathroom. Southwest. East. South. Straight down. He's under the... I can't get them out of my bare hands. Yeah, just separate those back out again. If I could level the floor up with a machete. Pay dirt. Well, these bones are pretty oddly shaped. I think this must have been born deformed. Great. Let's just pick up the... Yep, you're coming with me. Yep. It's fine. It's fine. We're carrying a fucking deformed dead kid who's also an angry ghost. This is totally fine. Nothing unusual about this. Okay, I think I've got everything. Simone. How do I destroy him? I mean, if I bring him back, he'll be undead. I have no idea. Maybe there's something looks over. Okay, let me just quickly double check what this says about destroying him. Place it in the fire and death. Okay, dress it up like... Okay, so I just need to go put... And I just need to go put him in the place full of... With the fireplace and the dead animals. And then... and then dress his fucking corpse up. It's weird, man. This is a weird thing to do. Remains. No, I need to use apron on remains. They won't go together. Okay, use remains on the floor. I guess it becomes a room of fire and death. Mm-hmm. Yep. Use welding mask. Somehow, I don't think this has improved his looks. Yep. And then read aloud. Clatu Verata Nicto. Here goes nothing. In this hall of death, and by the light of Prometheus's gift, I call thee. I bring thee gifts that may tempt thee back. I bring thee thy helm, that thou would be masked. I bring thee thy armor, that thou would be clothed. And I bring thee thy sword, that thou would be armed. Come! Come! I don't know why I'm doing that ridiculous. Come! That's how you summon a demon, how you scare, like, frighteningly summon a ghost. Maybe I should have planned this better. Shit. Right, well, I guess I thought that was going to be the last episode, but guess having one more episode tomorrow when I've fucking played back up to that point. Right, well, that's going to be all for me for now. I've been your mother out Uncle Sideways, and well, bye.
Is it done? Okay, cool. So I'm just gonna quickly tell you about some links in the description. Not gonna take up too much of your time because you've probably got other things to do and other videos to watch. So in the description there, you're gonna find a link to my Patreon if you want to support the channel, support me. Feel free to click that link and help me out down there. You'll also find a link to my Discord server where I talk a lot of bullshit and occasionally play games with folk. So maybe go down there, follow, join that Discord. Let's have a chat, you guys. Let's have a bit of an old chin wag. And you'll also find my Twitter where I occasionally post dumb things. I think that's about it. Yeah, so I'm gonna go away now. Bye.